components of 4, Chapter 2, Class 6. Objectives of the lesson are to introduce the concept of vitamins as one of the components of food that help protecting body from diseases, and the lesson will also explain the meaning, function, sources and efficiency diseases caused by the deficiency of vitamins in our diet. Various components of food, as we know, are carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals and dietary fibers, and vitamins and minerals are known as protective food. So what are these vitamins? A vitamin is an organic molecule that is an essential micronutrient which an organism needs in small quantities for the proper functioning of its metabolism. Essential nutrients cannot be synthesized in the organism either at all or not in sufficient quantities, and therefore must be obtained through the diet. That means from the food that we eat. Now you may ask, what is an organic molecule? So an organic molecule is a substance found in living systems, mainly made of carbon and other elements such as nitrogen, oxygen and hydrogen. Now let us start with vitamin A. Vitamin A is also known as retinol. Some of the facts about vitamin A are, our body gets vitamin A from carotenoids and retinoids. Our body can also make vitamin A from carotenoids obtained from green leafy vegetables. And the most common carotenoid is beta-carotene. And enzymes such as dioxygenase in the small intestine split beta-carotene to produce vitamin A. Some of the sources of vitamin A are milk, liver, carrots, pumpkin, egg yolk, capsicum, butter, cod liver oil, spinach and broccoli. The deficiency diseases caused due to lack of vitamin A in our diet is night blindness. It is also known as nyctalopia. Symptoms of night blindness are poor or complete loss of vision in darkness. And the treatment of night blindness include, we have to eat more green leafy, yellow and orange colored vegetables, milk, fish and liver in our diet. And by intaking vitamin A supplements as per doctor's recommendation and surgery if necessary. The next vitamin is vitamin B. It is a group of vitamins such as vitamin B1, B2, B3, B5, B6, B7, B9 and B12. B1 is known as thiamine. It is found in whole grains, meat and fish. Vitamin B2 is known as riboflavin and is found in eggs, green vegetables, kidney and liver. Vitamin B3 is known as niacin and is found in fish, chicken, turkey, green peas, brown rice, peanuts and mushrooms. Vitamin B5 is known as pantothenic acid and is found in dairy products, mushrooms, lentils, peas, meat, poultry, nuts. Vitamin B6 is known as pyridoxine and is found in soybeans, chicken, turkey, banana and oats. Vitamin B7 is known as biotin and is found in walnut, peanut, egg yolk and cereals. Vitamin B9 is known as folate and is found in fresh fruits, juices, spinach and whole grains. Vitamin B12 is found in fish, meat, eggs, chicken and turkey and is known as cobalamin. Vitamin B and deficiency diseases. Deficiency of vitamin B1 causes beriberi. Deficiency of vitamin B2 causes aryngoflavinosis. Deficiency of vitamin B3 causes pellagra. Deficiency of vitamin B5 causes acne. Deficiency of vitamin B6 causes pink eye and epilepsy. Deficiency of vitamin B7 causes impaired growth in infants, decreased hair and nail growth in adults. Deficiency of vitamin B9 causes megaloblastic anemia. Deficiency of vitamin B12 causes megaloblastic anemia and pernicious anemia. Next is vitamin C. Vitamin C is also known as ascorbic acid. It is the first vitamin to be chemically produced in 1933. It helps in the growth and repair of tissues, healing of wounds, form an important protein used to make skin, tendons, ligaments and blood vessels. Deficiency of vitamin C causes scurvy. It is a condition caused due to severe lack of vitamin C in our diet. What are its symptoms? Weakness, feeling tired, sore hands and legs, bleeding gums and bleeding skin. How can it be treated? By taking vitamin C supplements, eating citrus fruits and other sources of vitamin C. So what are the various sources of vitamin C? Various sources of vitamin C are orange, guava, strawberry, kiwi fruit, lime, bell peppers, lemon, and Brussels sprouts. Next is vitamin D. It is also known as calciferol. It is a group of fat-soluble vitamins and it is responsible for increasing intestinal absorption of calcium, magnesium, and phosphate. Deficiency of vitamin D causes rickets in children and osteomalacia in adults. Treatments for rickets, usually treated by increasing a child's intake of vitamin D and calcium by eating more foods that are rich in calcium and vitamin D, taking daily calcium and vitamin D supplements, having a vitamin D injection each year, and standing in sunlight during midday also helps our bodies to make vitamin D. The sources of vitamin D are tuna fish, trout fish, mackerel fish, and salmon fish, their skins, and fish liver oil as well as mushrooms. Next is vitamin A. It is also known as tocopherol. It is a fat-soluble vitamin. Deficiency of vitamin E causes mild hemolytic anemia due to fragility of red blood cells, and it also causes degeneration of neurons. The treatment can be taking vitamin E-rich food in our diet and vitamin E supplements from time to time. Some of the sources of vitamin E are sunflower seeds, almonds, dry roasted, sunflower oil, safflower oil, hazelnuts, dry roasted, peanut butter, peanuts, dry roasted, corn oil, and spinach. Next is vitamin K. Vitamin K is also known as phylloquinone. Its major role in our body is in blood coagulation or clotting of blood. Its deficiency causes vitamin K deficiency bleeding in newborns and in adults, small blood clots underneath nails. It can be treated by taking vitamin K supplements and eating vitamin K rich food. Some of the sources of vitamin K are Swiss chard, broccoli, cauliflower, turnip green, spinach, and locally grown green leafy vegetables. So what is our conclusion from today's lesson? We can conclude that we should eat foods which are rich in different vitamins in order to avoid deficiency diseases in our body. And vitamins are the protective. The vitamins have protective function in our body. They are the protective food. Then what are the deficiency diseases? The diseases that occur due to lack of nutrients over a long period are called deficiency diseases or nutritional disease. Deficiency of one or more nutrients can cause diseases or disorders in our body. For example, wheat is rich in carbohydrates but poor in nutrients like proteins. Therefore, we should have a balanced diet and we should take vitamin-rich food from time to time by preparing a list and very often visiting a doctor and receiving his recommendations. Thank you.